I think I was still in maybe secondary school when they were doing I Need to Know. Okay, then being a known phrase and how do I cope with it? Well, I think I literally grew up, or rather in my conscious adult years, I grew up being popular. So it sort of became like how you wear a shoe, how you wear a dress, or how you make your hair. It sort of became something that I got used to. I wouldn't say I'm used to it because it's really a bit, I won't say confusing or difficult going somewhere and somebody must know you everywhere you go. It's a bit, it throws me off my balance sometimes, but I'm growing into my own and becoming comfortable. My earlier years, like a few years back, I struggled with being, you know, famous and all of that. So, but I think I'm handling it pretty better these days. I'm a very at home kind of person. I do not like to go out. I'm a geek. I'm a glasses wearing, always in a book kind of person. And I think fame has made me come out of my shell. You know, I'm easy with people. I like people, so that's easy. But going out, going for events, doing interviews, I do not like interviews. It has to be like the most scary thing ever, you know. And it's changed me a lot in a sense that it's made me come out of my shell, even though I do not go for events, but I know that I have to start going now. It's made me a whole lot more outgoing, in quotes. So I think that's pretty much. Oh, Nollywood has given me so much. Nollywood has given me so much. Like, I get so much favors. People are always giving me stuff. I always get lots of free stuff. I go somewhere, someone always knows me. I always jump the queue, not on purpose. People always make me jump the queue. I get lots of opportunities. I get lots of opportunities handed over to me. I don't know. I don't know how my life would have been without the fame, because I don't know. I think it kind of makes life a whole lot more easier, you know, I think. Although on the downside, my privacy. Oh God. Interviews, turning things around, changing topics, you know, things that we didn't even discuss. And then you see this and I'm like, what kind of, what's this? I didn't say this, you know. It's I think it's mainly my privacy and having to come out of my shell. I think that's been the hardest thing for me with being popular. For me, that's been my hardest challenge. Oh yeah, then people insulting you. People that do not know you just come up to you and say, oh Moyo, you've added weight. Oh Moyo, your hips are too big now. Oh Moyo, you should lose weight. Oh Moyo, this is that. Moyo, why didn't you make your hair? Moyo, this is that. Like, people literally feel like they own you. Like, everybody has an opinion about your life. Like, people just come up to me and tell me I should do this, I should do that. And I'm like, okay. Okay. Like, you're not my aunt, you're not my father, you're not my mother. And so rest in peace. Who are you to tell me to do this? But everybody literally feels like they own you. So that's the downside. I don't go out. I don't keep like different boyfriends. I'm not doing anything notorious. I don't understand why I'm like a controversial person. But I think people just like to make me controversial. And I think that's why. I think press has made me controversial, basically, because honestly, I don't know why my posts go viral. and I don't understand it because I don't really know what I do that is controversial. If we dig deep, there's really, like, I don't think I've even gotten controversial yet. Like, I've not even done anything bad yet. No, I'm not telling. there are many. I'm not bringing it up because I noticed that if I do not talk about it, it dies. If I talk about it, it starts. A lot of people have so many misconceptions about me. Where do I start? If you ask me a direct one, maybe, but there are too many. Okay, yeah, concerning the round scales, I think I did quite like a few. Not so many, maybe like 6-7 movies that I portrayed being a round scale. And I think people do not know how to separate reality from fiction. And I think they just naturally, you know, put that together and just assume that that is how Moyo is. So does not necessarily bother me so much, because I remember I was doing TV. I just finished Tinsel that year, and now we're married with Amaka Igwe, may her soul rest in peace. And I went for a break in 2010 to like 2012. So when I came back in 2012, I wanted to do movies, and I wanted movies that were bad, you know, so I opted for this kind of roles, and people just assume that, oh yeah, she's doing it so well, she has to be that kind of person, and it's fine, it means I'm doing my job well. So my male fans are, I see them like a part of my life, and most of them don't really know me. They know the me on screen. So I feel when they're talking to me, it's like they're talking to somebody else. Like they say so many things that don't even make sense. And I'm like, dude, no, that's so wrong. Like I'm not even digging you or feeling you. You're not talking to me as me. So everything you're saying is just wrong. You know how it is when somebody's toasting you and the person doesn't know you and the person is saying, you know, it doesn't make any sense in your ear. You know, most people see the Moyo on TV, the glamorous, the daredevil, the controversial. So when they come to me, they're coming to me with that whole screen thing and it's not working. So it basically just doesn't work, that's it. Most embarrassing, none that I can remember. I hardly get embarrassed, so hey. Well, I'm on a little break for myself because I really needed to find out who I am, in the sense that I spent so many years playing different characters. I'm not really sure who I am again, so I took out a little bit of time to find myself, rediscover myself, you know, do a bit of traveling, and I'm just basically chilling and taking it easy right now. In the next couple of years, oh my goodness, this is like my father asking me a question. My dad always asks me this, oh, so what do we do in the next 5 years, what in the next 2 years question. I know God is a huge part of my life, and I believe in his plans for me. I'm walking towards my dreams. I've learned not to share everything with the public, so I still would like to keep some of my dreams and aspirations for the next few years close to my chest and just keep, you know, taking a day at a time, one step after the other. But I would really, really love to be able to say that in a few years' time, I've helped a lot of people. That is really, really important to me. I've really, really really like to be able to say that, yes, because of me, this person is here, because of me, this person has done this, because of me. That's, I would really, really like. Oh, growing up was fun. Growing up was fun. I'm the first one, and I come from a family of five, although we've expanded now. Growing up, we were five. And I was the first one, so I naturally had that responsibility, authority thing going on. And growing up was fun. We had boat rides, you know, Christmases, we had Christmas parties. It was fairly decent. Well, you see, the thing about life is that whatever it is that you do, it's always an avenue to making money from elsewhere or gathering resources from elsewhere. You know, that's the thing. The thing about Nollywood is that it's an amazing platform. Through Nollywood, you can make billions. That's a fact. You know, it's a very good platform. We're getting there. We're getting to an extent where we'll be able to say that Nollywood is generating so much money. But even despite the fact that we're not there yet, we can get better opportunities because people know us. So we can present contracts, we can do stuff that can also generate us some resources. So it's a great platform too. Why not? Of course. Nollywood is the only difference between Nollywood or entertainment, basically, is the fact that people know about it. It's just the same as being in a workplace, being in your workplace, for instance. You can't say that everybody here is a genuine friend to the other. Neither can you say that the friendships here are real. It's the same thing. The only difference is entertainment. Everybody knows us. I don't know about that saying. I hear people say it. I'm not exactly sure about how I feel about it. I just, like, my friends, my female friends, I hardly fight with them. Like, so I really don't know about that saying. I can't speak for myself because I really don't buy into that saying because it doesn't really showcase itself in my life. It's not a reality in my own life. I would love to be a therapist. I love to talk to people. I love to help people. I love to see people grow. I would love to be a therapist. I like to just, you know, and of course I know I'll have been singing, definitely. Yes, I love to be a therapist and I'll definitely have been a singer if I was not acting. As far as possible, whatever it takes, I give it 100%, whatever. I've done the worst things. I've cut my hair, I've rolled in mud, No, I'm not going nude. I think whatever story it is that I'm telling would not necessarily have to see me go nude. So, nah. I haven't worked with Ramsey. I would love to work with Ramsey. I haven't worked with... RMD. I haven't worked with RMD. I would love to work with RMD. I think that's all I remember now. I'm a woman, it's a man's world. I really don't care. Do what you have to do, I do what I have to do. Nah, I'm not. I'm unfortunately not a feminist. I understand everybody's opinion, I respect everybody's opinion, but I'm a woman, like I'm female, like. And I believe a man should be a man. I'm not. I feel everybody has a place and everybody should be in a place, and I really cannot even care less. do what you have to do, I do what I have to do, I don't give up. I would like to know the answer to that question as well. Unfortunately, we both can't answer that question now, can we? We can't. Am I single, complicated, in a relationship? Can I say I'm married? Secretly married. Oh my God, Moyo is secretly married. No. I don't know, man. I don't know. Well, I believe the person that falls in love with me and that I fall in love with would not be selfish enough to ask me to just quit, you know, but that question is really dicey, because you should be able to sacrifice everything for love, right? I know it's weird, but I might actually think about it. Nah, maybe. Who knows? You never can tell until you're in that position. I never say never. It depends. God might just say that, Moyo, it's time for you to quit. If God says yes, then who knows? No, I don't think I get that anymore. Like, I think growing up I used to get lots of comments and stuff, but no, I don't think I get. On the contrary, I get quite lots of amazing comments about my body. People won't think I've done surgery, so nah, I don't think I get that. No, I have not done surgery. I'm just a Yoruba girl. No. For people coming into Nollywood, what advice would I give to them? Well, I think it's important they know what they want. Like, if Nollywood is not your passion, I wouldn't advise you to come. And apart from that, you need to find what your strength is. You could be better behind the cameras, in front of the cameras. Like, we all need each other. Like, we cannot exist without the person handling the camera. We can't exist without the director. We can't exist without the costumers. So basically, everybody in the industry is important. So I think it's important people realize this is where the passion is before they start coming to the industry. And again, they need to be really patient and be sure this is what they want, because if it's not what you want, trust me, every single day you'll be frustrated. Hi guys, my name is Moyo Lawal. Keep watching Broadway TV. Don't touch that dial.